The SKOGU 2024 has brought several interesting results in the field of prostate cancer, and I would like to discuss the two main abstracts that were, in my view, interesting, but in my opinion, both are not practice changing. The first abstract reported on the CONTACT-02 trial. This is a phase 3 randomized study investigating the combination of tezolizumab and cabozantinib compared to an RP switch in the first line setting of metastatic castration resistant prostate cancer. The primary endpoint of this study was progression-free survival, and the overall survival was a secondary endpoint. The combination of atezolizumab and cabozantinib has demonstrated a significant improvement in the PFS. However, in absolute terms, this was a relatively small improvement of a couple of months. And moreover, the overall survival was not significantly better with this combination, even though the median overall survival was rather low, since quite a large number of patients with visceral metastasis was included. So the discussion of this study, it has to be said that the comparator arm of RP switch is, in my opinion and in the opinion of other experts, a rather weak comparator arm. Usually we treat these patients with docetaxel or cabazitaxel chemotherapy, and therefore the results need to be interpreted with caution. In my opinion, this combination is not going to be introduced in the treatment of mCRPC in Switzerland or in Europe, despite the positive nature of this trial. The second study is the BREAKAWAY phase 2 randomized trial. This is a very interesting trial that tested the possible synergy between abiraterone and the PARP inhibitor olaparib. Only patients with a BRCA1 or BRCA2 or ATM mutations could be included. In total, approximately 60 patients were included in 3 arms. So each arm contained only 20 patients. One arm received single-agent abiraterone, another single-agent olaparib, and the third received the combination of both agents, so abi plus olaparib. And the response rate was the primary endpoint, and this was clearly higher in the combination of abiraterone and olaparib, and also all the other efficacy parameters were improved with olaparib and abiraterone combination. Especially the PFS was much longer with the combination as compared to single agent. However, it has to be said that this is a very selected patient group. Also, it's a very small study. And finally, it was, even though a crossover was allowed, it did not formally test the combination versus the pre-planned sequence of the agents. So I think this study proves that indeed olaparib and abiraterone have a synergistic effect. And I think this is hopeful in view of the fact that the PARP inhibitors are nowadays tested in phase 3 in earlier treatment lines, such as metastatic hormone-sensitive prostate cancer. And it also proves that patients who have a BRCA mutation really benefit from a PARP inhibitor. But for the time being, this does not change what we do in clinical practice.